nationally acclaimed actor, model, and internationally known rock star. Put your hands together and make a New Orleans welcome from Mercury recording artist John.
How you doing?
What do you think of our great city, John?
Feels great to be back here. I like this. This is a nice, intimate atmosphere. Huh?
Absolutely. Did you get to do any partying last night? I know you came into town yesterday. Did you get to do any partying in New Orleans or anything like that?
Every time I come to this town, that's all I do.
And you're gonna start off with a little song for us, right?
Okay, you got it. I've been staring at the beach. The world seems like this. Yes, I'll put this one on for life. I see a tear from your eyes. Did you laugh so hard that you cried? When I served my secrets on a silver tray to you.
Yeah.
Anywhere, the majority of the songs from that album were written in a trailer in London.
Yeah, my own little trailer park under a bridge. And it was, I tried to bring the trailer home, but it didn't fit the overhead compartment of the airplane. I was doing a film over there last year, a little independent European movie called The Leading Man. And on the set of the film, there's nowhere to run, nowhere to hide, you know, and there's all this downtime in movie making. So they'd send me off to my trailer and, there's nothing to do. There's no phone, there's no TV, and I don't crochet, so I picked up the... Eventually, you know, I started writing, you know.
Kept you busy then.
Yeah. Oh, it was a lucky trail. All right, now, does anybody out there have a question? Rob, we have one over
here. Got one right here.
Hi, my name is Felicia Choulette. I was wondering how you got in the singing business.
Well... Some guy named Louis Cyphier showed up at my house and signed my name in blood. Nobody saw Angel Heart down here, huh? Just for us tourists. I always wanted to be a rock singer. It's just something, I don't know, from very early age, I just wanted to play guitar and sing in bands. I mean, so by the time I was 14 or so, I was just committed. That was all I was going to do. So by the time I guess I was 20 or so, I got a record deal and been here ever since.
Is in the audience. She's obviously a big fan of yours, and she's also sitting next to another fan who I believe has a question.
Oh yeah, she's got a question. Stacy, what's your question?
Hi, I'm Stacy. Nice to meet you. Can I take you out tonight? The big question everybody wants to ask.
I'm easy.
I wanted to ask you, John. As a back in the '80s when Bon Jovi first came out. You know, you changed the direction of the music in the 80s. I mean, it was cool all of a sudden for a rock band to do ballads. How did that make you feel as an artist?
That's pretty interesting. I guess the band didn't really make an impact. By the time my third record came around, I remember earlier on, the first two records, when radio was playing a lot of things like techno-English-y kind of stuff, maybe like Tears for Fears, you know, it was really big. We'd have to go to radio stations and bang on the door and beg them to play a song on the first couple records. But by the time the Slippery When Wet album came out, and it was such a phenomena for all of us, it did seem to change a lot. You know, it changed radio, it changed MTV, it changed our lives forever. And it was good for me because I like writing ballads once in a while. You know, it's fun.
John, do you want to play another song for us?
Sure.
Please?
This was... You made me think of this one, but this is, I guess, in the unplugged fashion, a real rock song that we'll just play a different take on.
Tommy used to work on the docks. He went on strike, hit down on his lucky tongue. It's too hard.
I swear, living on a prayer.
That's a lot for love. Give me a shot. Oh, oh, we're halfway there. Yeah.
Oh, living on a prayer.
Take my hand. We'll make it, I swear.
On the new B97. And John, obviously Bon Jovi was very successful. What made you decide to venture off on your solo projects? Money.
No, did I say that? No. The thing was, last summer we were on the end of the These Days tour, and it was quite successful, and we had a very good time out there. But I realized that it was time to take a break from it, only because though the experiences were wonderful, they were the same. No matter what we did at night, we did it together. And the way that we really reinvented it during the Keep the Faith album, after my doing Young Guns and Richie doing Stranger in This Town, I felt that it was time for that again. So Richie's doing a solo record right now, and Tico's pursuing his art, his painting. And Dave Bryan's doing a record with Dr. John right now.
Wow.
So everybody's doing something creative to bring back to the fold next year. So hopefully, you know, we'll continue to evolve as a band.
Now, John, speaking of Bon Jovi, I got to ask a question for the guys listening out there. Richie Sambora, you've met his wife, Heather Locklear. What's she really like? Hey. Red-blooded.
She's actually beyond what you'd even hoped that she could be. She's a sweetheart. She really is. not like me.
Oh, I don't know about that, John. One of the most attractive things about you is your vulnerability and the fact that you've been with the same woman for 17 years and two children.
And
what is your quality time with your family like? How do you separate that? You know, the professional thing and the family time.
You know, I mean, but this, you got to understand, this is a great way to make a living. You know, anyone out there or anyone listening, believe me, life on the road isn't too bad. But, you know, they tolerate it, I guess. And, yeah, they, I guess they do, you know. So, you know, I'm lucky. I really am. I got a band that still talks to me and a wife and kids that still talk to me. So I'm pretty happy about it.
All right, let's get another question from the crowd over here. We'll go live to Kim Diamond.
Okay. What's your name? Marlena.
Marlena,
what
are
you?
Hi.
Hi, John. I just wanted to say I love you.
Thank you.
I followed you from way back. But that doesn't make us
you know.
Old?
Yes. Oh. But I want to say to you that I respect you highly because of the writer you are, the musician you are, and mainly I wanted to say, just like she had just said, I respect you because of the family man you are, and you keep your life private, and I see that all the time.
This is doing nothing for my sex life. I just want you all to know, we always talk about my, you know, what a wonderful human being. I like it when girls throw themselves at me. Let's get right to the point here. What is this holy stuff, you know? Forget it.
He's got a great personality.
And what, hon? She's
still... I'm married, too, for 12 years, and I just wanted to say that. I really respect you for that. And I
all
think you
right.
Oh, that's sweet.
All right, Rob Holloway over here, live with Annie.
Hi, I'm Annie.
Hi, Annie.
Just wondering, have you discovered any new talents out there lately?
Aside from these guys who I haven't introduced yet, Everett Bradley over here
all
playing
right.
the percussion. And Bobby Bandiera playing the guitar. There isn't enough hours in the day for me to do any production or, you know, doing what I've done in the past, finding bands and doing that. I haven't done that for quite a while, no.
Now, since we're asking questions about your wife, your movie... no, this is better, don't worry. Destination Anywhere, your movie with Demi Moore, the love scene with Demi Moore, is your wife, what's her reaction to that?
Well, you see that? Now we can talk, you see? Now we're...
There we go.
This is under the guise of, you know, honey, I was only acting. And then you ask the director for about 6 more takes. He says, we've run out of film. I said, that she'll never know.
What did inspire Destination Anywhere? And how did you get Demi Moore and Kevin Bacon involved in the project?
I pleaded. I begged. You know what? When I was making this record, I think with everything that I approached this record with, I wanted it to be different. If nothing else, I wanted it to be different. From the aspect of coming here with an acoustic guitar instead of the usual arena to making what I think is a very new sounding record to this film, Destination Anywhere, I was dreading the idea of having to do videos. And I think that 15 years ago when all of us watched MTV for the first time, it was great. It was wonderful because you could see music for the first time. But I've really grown tired of the cartoons and the game shows and the same old video with the blurry things that don't mean anything to do with the songs. And so what I thought was, why don't we make a movie out of a record, out of an existing record? And we took key lines of lyrics and we centered it around one of the songs, August 7th, 415. And we wrote a story around that. And when I had the concept together, I was able then to approach Demi and Kevin and Whoopi and Annabelle Ciora and ask them if they wanted to take part in something new. And fortunately for me, you know, it worked with their schedules and we knocked it out.
I've seen it. It's very good.
Thank you.
You definitely should check it out. It's Jon Bon Jovi live at the House of Blues on the new B97. You guys ready for another song?
This was written when I was down here for the Super Bowl. This is called The Queen of New Orleans. She said, baby, I love just like your songs. The beat ain't fair. It's just the words are all wrong. It's time to back the bag. It's time we just moved on. She sang, Johnny, I'm gone, gone, gone. Gone. Me and Lee, some 9 to 5 in a burgundy dress, looking fine, a bit of French wine. A Cajun queen with another side. She was a schoolboy's dream, I was out of my mind. She was looking fine. Almost
hands in a cookie jar. She was more than a girl, she was his cabaret star. I was the deer in the lights of a speeding car. Cause nothing's what it seems. She was the Venus of Milo in her sister's jeans. Ooh, I was dancing with the queen of New Orleans. Ooh, dancing in the streets of New Orleans. Ooh, dancing cheek to cheek in New Orleans. Ooh, it was almost like a dream. The queen of New Orleans. Ooh, dancing in the streets of New Orleans. Ooh, nothing cheek to cheek in New Orleans. Ooh, dancing with the queen down Bourbon Street. Ooh, I was dancing with the queen of New Orleans.
Songs on the CD, Queen of New Orleans. And John, just for all the available gentlemen in the audience, is she still around this area?
I think so, over at my favorite establishment where they do the hoochie coo.
Which one would that be? There's so many of them around here.
Well, I don't want to give it away because then, you know, I'll have to start paying to get in there.
We had a young lady call in this morning and she just absolutely had to know. Of course, I would never ask this, John, but, you know, for the listeners, anything.
Right.
Are you a boxers or a briefs man?
I don't wear underwear, I gave him.
I told you he slept in a buff.
Speaking of underwear, what's the strangest thing any young lady has thrown on the stage at you during a concert?
Her little brother? No. I don't know. You know, I've had all those rotten, good cliche, rotten, dirty underwear, keys.
So we'll leave that alone.
Credit cards. I used that credit card for about 6 months, too.
Did it have a guy's name on it?
No.
The husband? No?
No.
Raj, do we have another question over here?
Hi, I'm Tracy. I was just wondering what kind of music you listen to when you're driving in your car by yourself and with your kids.
Oh, with the kids. Actually, with the kids. You know what? No, believe it or not, it's Simon and Garfunkel's Greatest Hits.
Oh, okay.
That's big in my car. That's big. You know? I tell you a goofy story. Is I was trying to pick what would be the second single on the album. And it was a couple weeks ago, and I was in my car, and I was home for a change. And I put in a copy of the album because I would have a little peace and quiet. And I'm driving down the street, and the windows are down. It was summertime. It was feeling pretty good cranking the album up. And I pulled up to a stoplight, and I thought to myself, all I need to do is like get recognized listening to my own record by myself in the car. I said, boy, the cool factor just sinks to zero, you know? So I put all the windows up. I didn't want to turn the record down because I was listening. I was trying to decide the single. I put the record of the windows up, and I sort of positioned myself half behind the car that was next to me and just blocking the guy behind me so like nobody could get next to me. But other than that, you know, I flipped through the radio a lot. I'm glad to hear that B97 is playing Delamitri because I'm glad to see that band's finally going to get a break. It's a great rock band. The Wallflowers is like my favorite new band of the year. So it's usually like the great storytelling rock bands.
Now, speaking of your kids, you have a 4-year-old and a 2-year-old who weren't around in the heyday of when Bon Jovi kicked off. What do you do when like a fan comes up and wants your autograph with your kids, or how do you explain that to them?
Oh, we had this discussion one day because my daughter didn't quite understand, you know, when she came home from nursery school and she said to me, "You're John Bon Jovi." I said, "Yes, honey, I am. And you're Stephanie Bon Jovi." And she says, "Well, the teacher told me that you're John Bon Jovi." Yes. So just, you know, you got to start to like think of me like Barney, you know, people, you know, for your crowd, you know, all the girls like you, you know, look up at that big purple thing for no reason whatsoever. And, you know. I said, "Well, that's what they do around daddy, you know." And she says, "Can you sing that song?" And you know, I said, "Who sings better, me or Barney?" She says, "Barney."
But you're much better looking. Kim Diamond,
I have a lady over here with a special question.
I'm Gina Braveshine. Nice to meet you.
Hi, Gina.
First, I have to say hi to Mom and hi to Todd.
Wait a second. Give me that question.
My question is, would you take off those cool sunglasses so we can see them?
Oh, come on.
I'm blind. I'm a vampire. I'm a vampire. Vampires are...
It's not quite 4 o'clock yet.
No.
Ladies, what do you think of the eyes?
Okay.
The cameras are going nuts.
They're killing me.
John, what's your favorite song? What song are you proudest of as an artist?
It's hard to say. You know, every time you do an album, each one of those songs has special meaning. So this is my 9th album. It'd be very difficult to pick one or even 5. But, you know, there's certain songs that really stand the test of time. I mean, obviously, Living on a Prayer or Wanted Dead or Alive stand the test of time. I think Bed of Roses is standing the test of time for me. And there's certain things on this record that I think will, too. You know, August 7th, I think, will stand the test of time for me. And, you know, it's really difficult. You get too close to them.
I bet.
John Bon Jovi live from the House of Blues. We'll be right back with more... Holloway and Kim Diamond from the new B97 and the rest of the crew, along with our B97 listeners. We are experiencing something that nobody else will ever get to experience, ladies and gentlemen. Up close and personal with John Bon Jovi, a question and answer session. Now, do we have a couple of people in the audience that want to ask a couple more questions before we have him play another song?
I have one right over here.
Hi, John. I just wanted to tell you that back in December, I was out in California in the Rader Institute. I have a very serious eating disorder, and I was dying. And we had to make a list of our goals that we wanted to do before, for 1 year. You know, that we had to survive. What was my number one goal? And it was going to be able to see you in concert live. And the song that I...
That's pretty powerful, John. That's pretty powerful. That's, I mean, how do you feel about that?
Pretty, you know, it's amazing. Okay, but she wants to hear something here that she's going to put me to the test.
She wants to put you to the test.
Yes. The one song that I listened to over and over and over was Miracle, because knew to survive, it was going to take a miracle.
I can't tell you that I could play it, only because I don't remember.
Remember the chorus?
Take a miracle. Save us this time, and your savior has just left town. Won't need a miracle, cause your heart's on the line, and your conscience is calling you down. Lift your wings, I believe that you can fly. Something like that, right? For your thoughts now, baby, it looks like the weight of the world's on your shoulders now. I know you think that you're going crazy just when it seems everything gonna work itself out. You knock you right back down, and you say it ain't fair that a man walks when a bird can fly. We gotta kiss the ground. They kiss the sky, they say spirits live while man has to die. They promised us truth, now they're giving us lies. Won't take a miracle to save us this time, and your savior has just left town. Won't take a miracle, cause your heart's on the line, and heartbeat is slowing down.
bass line. Reaching for the sky. I don't know this line. You can, I'm leading, you can fly. All right, so. Only for you in that situation, but I've never performed that song ever. So that was a...
John Bon Jovi live from the House of Blues on the new B97. John, I think you could just hum for us forever and we'd be happy, satisfied.
All right, I think we have one more question.
One more.
Hi, my name is Julie, and I was wondering, what's life like in your hometown?
Oh, it's a great little town in the middle of New Jersey. I guess the town's about 300 years old, so it looks like a very New England-y kind of country kind of place. There's no city, you know, it's just a little borough. You know, it's like 17 cops and one schoolhouse and no movie theater, no restaurants, no nothing. So it's pretty out there, you know. It's about an hour and a half out of New York.
And could you sing I'll Be There For You?
I didn't know this show was going to be a quiz.
Shoebox.
Is he getting graded on this?
Yeah, I didn't pass the first one.
It's the All Request Bistro.
That's right.
I guess this time you're leaving. I heard your suitcase say goodbye. As my broken heart lies bleeding, you say true love is suicide. Because it's a quiz.
What do you think, guys? A plus here? A plus? It's John Bon Jovi live at the House of Blues. Now, John, I have to ask you, you are going to sing Midnight in Chelsea for us, right? There's a great little story behind this song that we'll ask him coming up. But first, we want to take a couple more questions before we go to another break. Kim?
Back in the 80s, when you guys first hit, you know, you were successful, was it overwhelming at any point where you just said, man, I can't believe this. It happened.
Oh, yeah. Like I said before, it took us three albums to get any kind of recognition. I remember walking through the quarter as an opening band for a band called Rat in 1985.
I remember that concert tour. Oh, my God.
And we were the opening act and walking through the quarter thinking, like, this ain't right. We should be headlining. And we couldn't even get our records on the radio. So when Slippery exploded and then New Jersey followed it, I mean, we had five number one singles and, you know, sold a gazillion records and... it was just, everything really kicked itself right in the butt. So to tell you the truth, I'm glad it didn't come any earlier. But when it came, and it came at that kind of magnitude, it's too much information to process. You know, it's just every day you're getting another phone call about another amazing record that was set. And it was overwhelming. You know, for a 25-year-old kid, it was really a lot.
I bet. Well, you have a question for John?
I have a question. Mm-hmm. My name is Nola Abair. Hi.
Hello. How you doing?
And TV does not do you justice. You are gorgeous and sexy.
What's your question? That goes without saying. I think everybody, all the ladies who think he's gorgeous, yes, that goes without saying.
My question is, where is your favorite place to be?
I don't know. I like going to Italy a lot. Italy's a gorgeous country.
A lot of places have surprised me in the world. You know, Turkey was an amazing place to go. But it, I don't know. I've got a lot of them. Paris is a great place to be. And New Orleans.
Well, yeah, you get to travel around a lot. We have another question for John?
I got a question for him.
Okay.
John, we was reading about the critics and stuff on the album, and we was kind of curious if this whole new album of yours is dedicated to the management team.
No. The song, August 7th, was my manager's daughter was... murdered last year on August 7th, and she's a six-year-old little baby, three houses from where she lives, and so there's a dedication to her on the record, and I think that that's been recognized now quite a bit, but no, you know, imagine somebody like dedicating a record to their managers. Jeez.
Yeah.
Jeez.
It's John Bon Jovi live at the House of Blues. We have Kim Diamond, Rob Holloway, I'm Charisse, and we have Scott also. We'll be right back with more John Bon Jovi on the new B97.
The Blues with more live John Bon Jovi on the new B97.
You're hearing John Bon Jovi. Now, John, you're going to sing a couple of more songs from Destination Anywhere, right?
Sure.
Okay.
We can do that. This was the first single. It's called Midnight in Chelsea.
You guys kind of had a collective group to write this song in London.
The way I met Dave Stewart, who was in a band called Eurythmics. Dave was a co-producer of this track as well as the co-writer. We got together one Sunday afternoon while I was doing a film in London, and he was over there doing, Bruce Willis was over there doing a film called The Leading Man. No, mine was the one that tanked. He did The Fifth Element. He did a big movie over there. And he invited a bunch of people over one Sunday afternoon, one of them being Dave Stewart, myself, and Prince Andrew and Sarah Ferguson were there with their kids. And I just thought Bruce was really uptight about security until I walked in there. I went, whoa, you know. So anyhow, everyone starts strumming these guitars and, like, you know, beating on spoons and books and what have you around there. And, no, Andrew doesn't have any rhythm at all, so he was like, you know, I'm off. And, but Dave and I, we came up with what was this chord progression, and, you know, I turned around and I just thought it sounded like a song, and I was having such a good time living in London that, I started telling this story to him when we got together, and, anyhow, it goes like this.
Like sticks, trade old licks and beat up chicks. I just smile and catch the groove. Got the girls all dressed in black, serious as heart attacks. Takes a little bit of getting used to. The old man with the whiskey stains lost the night, got his name. Poor wife, she sleep alone again. And it ain't hard. Understand why she's holding on to her own hand. It's midnight in Chelsea. Midnight in Chelsea. No one's asking me for favors. No one looking for a savior. They're too busy. Lone Ranger Jack sees a chauffeur took a dive. So the secrets to the sun. My leader in a magazine, I finally figured what it means. Be a saint, but not a queen. Two lustful lovers catch a spark. Chase the shadows in the dark. Someone's getting off tonight. So tight, disappears in a trail line. Somewhere someone's dreaming. But maybe it's alright. It's midnight in Chelsea. It's midnight in Chelsea. Chasing. No one's pinning the jeans on me. No one asking me to bleed. I'm the man that I want to be. With Chelsea girls sing sha la la la, sha la la la, sha la la la, sha la la la.
He's an actor, he's a model, he's a singer, he's a father, he's a husband, a heartthrob. Do you guys want to hear more from Jon Bon Jovi?
Let's play a little something old for you.
dead or alive. I walk the street with guitar on my back. I play for keeps, but I might not make it back. Been everywhere, and I'm standing tall to see the million faces. Well, I rock them all, yeah. I'm a cowboy, the steelers I ride. Want it, dead or alive. Well, I'm a cowboy, the night's on my side. Want it, dead or alive. Now I ride, dead or alive. I will drive, dead or alive, dead or alive, dead or alive, dead or alive, dead or alive.
We are live with John Bon Jovi from the House of Blues. We want to welcome everybody and thank everybody for coming today. And John, we wanted to ask you if you would sign this guitar for one of our listeners. We're going to do an actual drawing. So everybody who is here today has the opportunity to win this autographed guitar from John Bon Jovi.
Yeah.
All right, who wants it?
John, would you go ahead and pick a name for us, please?
Here it is. And the winner be Belinda Ducole. D-U-C-O-L-E. Belinda?
Belinda?
Oh, Ducote.
Is
that
here?
A T? Ducote? Belinda, you up there? There you go, baby. You
where
got
is she?
Yourself a guitar. Up top.
Come on, Belinda, make some noise. Now, John, there are no rules here. We were supposed to wrap up a long time ago, but we love you so much. So if you want to...
Yeah, let's play one more at least.
Right.
I don't know. This is the new single, so I guess I should play that for you, right? It's called Janie Don't Take Your Love to Town.
Sitting in, just watching you sleep. Wish I could sleep inside and be in some technical dream. With the air too thick for one of us to breathe. Not fool enough to think.
Yeah. From the CD Destination Anywhere.
One last question.
Yes.
Janie, where did you write that song?
Amsterdam.
No,
the
where?
Only when?
Where exactly were you in Amsterdam?
In sitting in the bathroom of a hotel room at 3 a.m. Yeah. The only decadent city, more decadent city than New Orleans is Amsterdam. Man. That should be like the sister city of New Orleans, you know? Every time I go there, I get in trouble, too. But good songs come out of bad situations. So, you know, I got Queen of New Orleans out of the hurricanes in this town, and I got a couple bottles of wine, and Richie gave me a headache in that town, and I wrote Janie. So, hooray for decadence, you know?
Are you staying in New Orleans and planning on getting in trouble tonight?
It would be a nice idea, but unfortunately, I'm off to Houston.
Oh.
I'm off to Houston right now, and then Fort Lauderdale tonight. So... you want to go with the romantic lifestyle of life on the road? You know, it's like 3 cities a day every day.
But it should be a lot of fun.
Nothing
for
but
us
fun.
Anyway.
Nothing but fun. I wish I were staying longer.
John, thank you so much for making this an amazing experience for us.
Well,
today.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. I had a great time. We'll see you again.
We want to thank the House of Blues for making this happen and the B97 listeners. John Bon Jovi live from the House of Blues. Kim Diamond, Rob Holloway, Charisse and Scott on the new B97.